Dear Dr. Ramesh, Professor Dev Roy from MIT, Professor Lawrence, Ms. Anuradha Gupta, Deputy CEO Gavi, other participants, ladies and gentlemen, I am happy to be part of this conference on a crucial point of discourse, Vaccines for All, COVID-19 Digital Tools to Empower Citizens. With December on the calendar, we as a global community have been engaged in a prolonged battle against COVID-19 for the better part of the year. While lives have been lost, but we have also seen resilience, hope, and selflessness amongst people, organizations, and nations. India represents a major proportion of the world's population as well as disease burden. And as a result, the challenges during pandemic were unique, and therefore the response at India level had to be curated, keeping in mind its vast population, diversity, and federal governance structure. Since the onset of pandemic, we followed a proactive, preemptive, graded, a whole of government and whole of society approach for the COVID-19 management. These included surveillance at points of entry and in community, ensuring adequate testing infrastructure, upgrading health infrastructure, ensuring logistics like oxygen, personal protection equipment, and N95 masks, capacity augmentation of healthcare staff, effective risk communication, and we also initiated our response early as we had our first meeting of joint monitoring group under the Director General of Health Services as early as 8th of January itself. Despite various constraints, effective planning, strategic management, and a robust institutional mechanism enabled India to keep its cases and deaths per million as one of the lowest amongst the world, including the developed countries. India has a cases per million of 7,068 and deaths per million of 103, which is 1/7 and 1/9 of the US respectively. With strong focus on clinical management and monitoring comorbidities, our fatality rate today stands at 1.45%, vis-a-vis a global average of 2.25%. The government constituted a group of ministers under Honorable Health Minister for continuous engagement, which provided necessary guidance under the overall directions of our Honorable Prime Minister. As we are inching closer towards the final stages of vaccine availability and delivery, ensuring success in this area will be another mammoth task. India's world-class research institutes are at the forefront of our nation's COVID response, currently working for vaccine research and large-scale production. At present, when there are 260 vaccine candidates in different stages of development globally, with 9 potential vaccines, including 3 indigenous ones as well, which are scheduled to be manufactured in India, India is well poised to take the challenge. With the help of India's apex regulator, the Drug Controller General of India, and Indian Council of Medical Research, we will ensure that there is no compromise on scientific and regulatory norms stretching from safety to efficacy while vaccines are given emergency use authorization. There is a vaccine task force and national expert group on vaccine administration for COVID-19 to provide technical guidance on procurement and identification of priority population groups. They have accordingly prioritized healthcare workers and frontline workers to be covered in initial phases besides people above 50 years of age as priority age group. India has always prided itself for its pharmaceutical and vaccination manufacturing industry. We have also been called the pharmacy of the world. Under our universal immunization program, India already takes up 12 million immunization sessions every year, covering 29 million pregnant women and 26 million infants. We already have an IT platform to manage logistics of vaccine supply chains and cold chain management, electronically monitored through 28,000 cold chain points. However, COVID-19 will require India to scale up its overall infrastructure and digital management capacities. We are ensuring logistics requirement in such a manner that there is minimal impact on existing healthcare services, especially national programs and primary care, including routine immunization. We will require flexible technology solutions across the entire gamut of vaccine inventory management, temperature monitoring, and tracking up to beneficiary level for multiple of millions of doses of vaccines around the country. These technology solutions are required to ensure effective transparency in distribution and will ensure inclusivity and equitable access to COVID vaccine. Throughout our COVID response, we have focused on incorporating digital interventions as part of our management. From Arogya Setu, which is already downloaded 166 million times for self-evaluation, contact tracing, to leveraging call record data through Itihas for detecting evolving clusters of cases, ICMR portal and COVID India portal supported by apps such as RT-PCR app and Facility app serves as repository of field data and enable us to take data-driven decisions and plan our interventions. Now, as we shift our focus to enhance service delivery of COVID vaccines, India has developed a real-time digital platform for COVID-19 vaccination delivery called COVIN, that is winning over COVID. This platform will account for different cold storage requirements of multiple vaccines, two or more dose adherence, and certification for vaccine recipients. It enables end-to-end beneficiary management, allows citizens to self-register and monitor his vaccination, allocation of vaccine sessions as per the priority criteria, SMS in 14 different Indian languages to citizens across the distribution of vaccine, mobile applications for vaccinations to conduct sessions, and in the end provide a QR code-based electronic vaccination certificate which can then be inserted into a digital locker for each and every citizen. The IT platform is also integrated with Aadhaar, our identity platform, and other photo IDs for beneficiary authentication, besides populating a unique health ID for all beneficiaries having Aadhaar. A critical part of this platform is also to electronically monitor adverse events following immunization. This will be the world's biggest platform end-to-end for vaccine delivery. Besides this electronic platform, we also have clearly delineated a capacity building strategy for the vaccinators utilizing digital tools and an IT platform called Integrated Government Online Training Portal. We also have a plan for community engagement focusing on educating them on various aspects of vaccination besides managing any confusion caused by misinformation or fake news. We realize that India's biggest strength in this endeavor will be the citizen of India and vaccinating a major part of country's 1.37 billion population will require effective Jan Bhagidari, that is people's participation. We are standing at a critical juncture on the road of defeating this pandemic. While international alliances globally are working on power of collaborative action, India, as the largest global supplier and producer of 60% of the world's vaccine, will support the global efforts through low cost, safe and effective vaccine availability, not only for the country, but as well as world. Thank you.